Okay, so this is a replay of I do takeoff and landings on my own. I'm still teaching myself how to fly in the simulator. This is X-Plane 11, using SkyMax Pro for the sky, and this is scenery from. It's in the Great Lakes, Lake Michigan. I just go from one little island to the other. This is an M20. And nothing really special other than in the end, I consider this call. I titled this video an indirect approach because it's not really a fancy setup for an approach. The whole thing is flown manually, and you'll see that although I do all the normal planning and speed and altitude and all that, the approach is not directly on. And it actually turns out to be a pretty smooth landing, maybe not approved by air traffic control in the real world, but the simulator wouldn't let you do it. They would crash you if it didn't work, and this worked out pretty well. So I'm not going to talk a whole lot in this video. I might do some review, like a rewind or whatever in the end, because just because I like to watch it from different angles. And again, this is more for me than is anyone else. This is not going to be long. I think this is only about 15 minutes, maybe. So enjoy. Go ahead and get on to me now, but I didn't have any lights on at all. Completely forgot that. Which just shows you I'm just practicing, not trying to be technically correct, obviously. I don't think I can turn them on in the mid. Nah. They're actually already on. Back to the flight. Okay, so jump out of the plane here for a second. So the runway I'm going to land at not this one, I'm pointing at with my mouse, but this one out here. And so the runway goes, if you'll see my mouse, goes in this direction. And I wasn't a Boy Scout and I haven't looked at the direction. I don't know if that's north, south, east, or west. But it goes in this direction and I'm approaching from here, but it's not an inline approach. I like to have comfortably, as a lot of pilots do, I kind of go in on it at the last minute. You'll see I'll kind of just bank and I'll have my speed and everything just correct. It'll be a good landing, but it's not something I do that often because I'm not real comfortable with it, but it turned out really nice. I'm still learning how to fly, I'm learning how to land, I'm learning how to take off, so anyone's watching this going, okay, yeah, we see that, big deal. I'm learning. I've been simming for a couple of months, and I've really got comfortable with this particular kind of plane. So, I'll let the video speak for itself. By the way, I'm flying manually. I hardly ever use autopilot. Now, in commercial jets, I'll use autopilot heavily, but in the smaller planes, I like to fly. So if I were to fly a real aircraft, I would be flying manually. I just enjoy that. I like the idea of me flying the plane and not the plane flying the plane. I get that why people do it, and I like to do it every now and then, but not most times. So you'll see some bumping up and down on landing, but I don't use autopilot, not to land, that for sure. And that there you hear is landing gear. Okay, so we'll look at this first through the captain's seat. So I'm at about 300 feet. Going down to about 60 knots. I'm holding it a little bit. It's a little bouncy here in a second. Settling in comfortably at about 55 knots. No, a little, about 70 knots. My apologies. Okay. And we're down. Okay, so let's back that up. Back it up to here. Go outside the aircraft. Look at it from out here. You'll see here that
crossover. Skip a big chunk. Wouldn't recommend doing this in a larger aircraft. Unless you have a parachute. Not the one to jump out of the plane with. Okay, and so let's back it up again to about here. Let's do it from a different angle. Oh, that's not what I wanted, but we'll get there. There's the turn. I'm like, where's the runway? Here it comes. About 3 seconds. 2, 1. Boom. Okay. So, I like to actually watch it before the landing gear comes down, about right here. To give you a perspective, there's my goal here. Hear myself coming in. There I am, that little dot there. Here I come in from that odd angle, which I actually saw a real pilot do a couple days ago, and I thought I'm gonna try that, as because I'm learning. I couldn't have got it any smoother than that, quite honestly. Nice. All right. And I'll end it here. Thanks for watching. This is T-Magic, and you are on the T-Magic Fly channel, where I occasionally come on and share some of my learning experiences as I am learning to be a flight simmer, flying all types of planes. And this was the indirect approach. T-Magic out.
This is a flight from a few days ago where I was actually working on a photo contest, which I decided not to do in my BN2 Islander. And I had a quite nice flight and landing here at dusk, and then after a little bit into the evening. I just thought you'd enjoy it, so sit back and enjoy. Not really much to talk about. Just enjoy the sights. By the way, this is in British Columbia. I'm going from PS01 to... Good question. Where was I going? That for a minute. Sorry about the background noise there. Let's see. Where was I going? BN2 Islander. I went from PS01 to CYQQ. And again, that's in British Columbia. So if you like this route, the scenery, I picked up the PS01 from Orbix, ORBX. The Sky is SkyMax Pro. The plane, BN2 Islander, is from TorqueSim. TorqueSim. I don't get paid to say any of that. It's just that if there's fellow simmers out there who like this, that's what it is. Okay, so I'll continue the flight here. Thank you.
By the way, you'll see some near misses here of mountains because I was taking screenshots outside of the plane for a photo contest. It's actually a photo contest put on by X Aviation in order to win a plane, but I actually went and bought the plane because I didn't feel like dealing with it at the time. So anyway, so I never used the screenshots, but it's really good scenery. I'll step out and show you around a little bit occasionally. This is an awesome aircraft. I take all the passengers out of it. They just start looking goofy after a while. Reflection on that water with those mountains is just really beautiful to me. That's one of my near misses. I didn't think of that earlier. I don't know. I apologize for all that loud. That's a very loud engine, but these headphones here muted out. Noise canceling. in a simulator. How about that?
There was really no plan for this particular flight. Actually, I was just going to take some screenshots and then just quit the program, but you'll see I decided to go on and found an airport and I landed at it, and it was a really nice landing, so I kept this and finally got it. I'm finally streaming it today. For those of you who are seeing this on YouTube, I do have a Twitch channel. It's twitch.tv/tmagicfly. So if I've mentioned streaming, I know there's a couple people that follow me on YouTube who don't follow me on Twitch. So when I mention stream, I do not stream as of yet live on YouTube, only on Twitch. And not professionally by any stretch. I'm not a pilot. I don't fly. Anyone who sees me fly will know that I'm not a pilot. If you've seen me take off, land, or fly, I fly pretty well, but if you see me take off or land, you'll see that I am a student in the X-Plane 11 simulator, strongly thinking about other simulators, especially Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. See how that goes, but for now I just enjoy X-Plane 11. I believe we're on, this is Vulcan version 9 last time I looked. The name of this particular session is an indirect approach, because the first stream session I did was with an M20 aircraft, and I did an indirect approach landing, so I just so happened decided to pull out this file because I saw it sitting there. I decided to cover this as well. I would probably name this something like Wonderful Scenery in British Columbia. Thinking about British Columbia, I see a Snowbird's jet, a lot like United States Thunderbirds, those type of teams, or Blue Angels. But one of their jets crashed the other day, killing their public affairs officer. She was a captain. It was really sad to see. Followed up anymore. I know the pilot got out. I've heard the pilot was severely injured. Don't know what his status is. This is a two-day-old story, so I don't know. But as I fly through British Columbia here, I'm thinking about that loss of life. Just hoping that she loved what she did. Why she couldn't get out, I don't know. Maybe because she wasn't used to flying. She was a public affairs officer. I don't know how well she was trained, if trained at all. I don't know. I know when I was in the Air Force, public affairs type people were not proficient in flying. Usually, there were some occasions when flyers would make it over to those kinds of positions, but I'm not familiar with the Canadian Air Force, only United States Air Force, as I was in there for 10 years and worked the type of job where I actually came in contact with public affairs officers. So I know enough to be dangerous. And that's been a long time ago. I was in during Desert Storm, Desert Shield, Desert Storm, those years. 10 years. You see all the moving around I'm doing in this particular. It was because I was trying to get certain angles when remember I was doing a screenshots on the outside of the plane. I'll show you here. But I was doing these screenshots, and as I was doing it, I was moving the plane around, probably in unnatural ways, so that I could get scenes like that. So I'd move it around to get particular kind of shots. Okay, so I'm gonna fast forward this a bit. See, look at the map, see if I can remember. Okay, so here is my destination that I end up in, CYQQ. I came from PS01. Don't remember at what point I said I think I'll go there. It's probably very soon here in the replay. You'll probably see me bank as soon as I decide let's go there. There it is. That's when I decided, let's go over there. I was looking at different options up here in the north and then spotted that, so. Okay. So I'll put it in regular play mode here. Just going to be across the water here and then to the left. I remember this well. It was really nice. Yeah, so I can tell I was lining up as I decrease my airspeed and start to work on my altitude a bit. Let me see how far off I was. Yeah, still had a little bit of a ways. Few adjustments. go from plane to plane, and you definitely, at least as I'm in learning mode here, you learn where to begin losing your altitude, working on that, when to learn how to, when to bring your airspeed down, how far to bring your